Good morning. Now let us go to the next lecture. Next article. And next article is about inner product of vectors. So let us go for it. Now how to go for this inner product of vectors? Just 1 minute. Okay. Let us consider n-dimensional space, and in this n-dimensional space we wanted to describe the vectors, the basis. Whenever we describe the vectors or basis in n-dimensional space, there are n number of elements of basis which are given by e1, e2, e3, dash dash en. N dimensional space always has n number of elements of basis in n dimensional space. Let us represent these elements as e1, e2, e3, e4, dash dash en. One element for one dimension, n elements for n dimensions. As the space is n dimensional space, there should be n number of elements of vector, elements of basis. Now if magnitude of each of these elements is unity, these elements of basis in n-dimensional space are known as unit vectors. If magnitude of all these elements of basis in n-dimensional space is unity, then all these elements of basis are known as unit vectors. It means that if we define a vector in n-dimensional space, there will be n number of unit vectors. For example, let us consider we have vector A and vector B, which is described in n dimensional space. Mathematically, it can be written as vector A is equal to E1 A1, or let me put it as it is, as this way, A1 E1 plus A2 E2 plus A3 E3 plus dash dash, and the final one will be AN EN, equation number 1. Vector B in the same n dimensional space may be B1 E1 plus B2 E2 plus B3A3 plus dash dash BN EN equation number 2. Vector A is described in n-dimensional space. Vector B is also described in n-dimensional space. And these are represented as A is equal to A1 A1 plus A2 A2 plus A3 A3 and so on up to AN AN. And vector B is described as B1 A1 plus B2 E2 plus B3 E3 plus dash dash so on plus BN EN. Here A1 A2 A3 A4 etc. are components of vector A along E1 E2 E3 etc. respectively, and B1 B2 B3 B4 etc. are components of vector B along the unit vectors E1, E2, E3, E4, etc. respectively. The components A1, A2, A3, A4, etc. of vector A and the components B1, B2, B3, B4, etc. for vector B are scalars. These are scalars. Then we want to study here inner product of vectors. I have prepared a background to study this inner product of vectors. Here we have vector A and vector B. Inner product of vector A and vector B is defined as, let me write it here, inner product of vectors A and B is equal to within a parenthesis A comma B. Inner product of vectors A and B is equal to within the parenthesis A comma B. This is known as inner product of two vectors A and B. This is further defined as summation over I is equal to 1 to n AI star into BI equation number 3. Inner product of two vectors is represented this way within the bracket vector A comma vector B, and mathematical definition is summation over I is equal to 1 to n AI star into BI. This AI star is corresponding to complex conjugate. We need this when AI and BI are complex. We need this when the components A1, A2, A3, etc., the components B1, B2, B3, etc. are complex in nature. In that case, we need formula 3 to define inner product of vectors A and B. If we have a look into equation 1 and equation 2, we find that A1, A2, A3, etc. are not complex in nature. B1, B2, B3, B4, etc. are also not complex in nature. They are just real. When the components A1, A2, A3, etc. and B1, B2, B3, etc. corresponding to the vectors A and B are real, then this inner product of vectors A and B can simply be defined as the sum of product of respective components of vector A and vector B. When the components of vector A and components of vector B are real in nature, then inner product of vectors A and B is defined as sum of product of corresponding components of vector A and vector B. This type of product of two vectors is defined as inner product of vectors. Here we have taken inner product of vector A with vector B. What will happen if we take inner product of vector A with A itself? Let us try to do this. Inner product of vector A with A itself. Within the bracket, what we have shown? A comma A. That is inner product of vector A with itself. And that will be equal to summation over I is equal to 1 to n AI star into AI. AI star into AI. This is generally written whenever the components are complex in nature. AI is a complex component. What is this AI star? This AI star is a complex conjugate of AI. And what is product of a complex number and its complex conjugate? Product of a complex number and its complex conjugate is square of magnitude of both of them. And mathematically, it can be written as modulus of AI square or square of modulus of AI. Product of the complex component AI and its complex conjugate is always defined as square of modulus of both of them. Mathematically, it can be written as AI within the modulus, square of the modulus. That is square of modulus of AI. Square of modulus of AI will provide us inner product of A with itself. This is further represented as equation number 4. Square of modulus of AI is further represented as this way. Using equation 4, we can find the magnitude or norm of vector A. Using equation 4, we can find magnitude or norm of vector A. Magnitude or the norm of vector A. How to find this? Norm of vector A is equal to this is the way of representation of, this is the symbol for representation of magnitude of vector A or norm of vector A. From equation 4, what will be this? From equation 4, this will be simply from equation 4, if you compare this with this, this norm of vector A will be simply square root of inner product of vector A with itself. Square root of inner product of vector A with itself. If norm of a vector is 1, vector A is known as unity vector. If norm of vector A is 1, vector A is known as unity vector. If norm of a vector is 1, it is also known as normalized vector. Whenever this is equal to 1, whenever this norm is equal to 1, vector A is known as normalized vector or unit vector. So whenever we have norm of a vector is equal to 1, vector A will be unity vector or it will be normalized vector. We can have vector A as normalized vector, we can have vector B as normalized vector. When we have different normalized vectors, let us suppose A is normalized vector, B is normalized vector, and inner product of vector A and vector B is equal to 0. A is normalized vector because norm of A is 1. B is normalized vector because norm of vector B is also 1. And if inner product of these two vectors is 0, vectors A and B are known as orthogonal vectors. Whenever inner product of vectors A and B is 0, such two vectors are known as orthogonal vectors. Vector A is orthogonal to vector B. In other words, vector B is orthogonal to vector A. Such vectors are known as orthogonal vectors. Now, the orthogonal vectors A and B are orthogonal to each other. If norm of A is unity, if norm of B is unity, A is normalized vector, B is also normalized vector, and if A and B are orthogonal to each other, then vectors A and B are known as orthonormal vectors. Norm of A and B, or let me just write vectors A and B are normalized when this is true. If norm of A and B both is 1, then we can say that vector A and B are normalized. One condition. Second condition, A and B are orthogonal. Vector A and B are normalized 1. Similarly, vector A and B are orthogonal. If this is true, if condition 1 and condition 2, both these conditions are true for vectors A and B, then vectors A and B are known as orthonormal vectors. Whenever vector A and vector B are normalized, meaning that norm of A is 1, norm of B is 1, further A and B are orthogonal to each other, A and B will be orthogonal to each other if their inner product is 0. Then these two vectors A and B are known as orthonormal vectors. Such two vectors are known as orthonormal vectors. What are the examples of orthonormal vectors? Let us go to three-dimensional space. Do you know three-dimensional space? In three-dimensional space, a vector can be splitted into three components mutually perpendicular to each other. And what are the unit vectors in three-dimensional space? Unit vectors in three-dimensional space are i, j, k are the unit vectors in three-dimensional space. I is unit vector, j is unit vector, k is unit vector, and therefore I is normalized, j is normalized, k is normalized. I and j orthogonal to each other, I and k orthogonal to each other, j and I orthogonal to each other, j and k also orthogonal to each other. And therefore, for a three-dimensional space, vectors I, j, k form a set of three orthonormal vectors. For three-dimensional space, the set of vectors I, j, k will form a set of three orthonormal vectors, because norm of I, j, k all is 1. That is, I is normalized, j is normalized, k is normalized, because I is unity vector, j is unity vector, k is unity vector. Further, I and j orthogonal to each other, j and k orthogonal to each other, I and k also orthogonal to each other, and therefore the three vectors I, j, k for a three-dimensional space will form a set of three orthonormal vectors. If we go for n-dimensional space, the elements of basis are n in number. The unit vectors are n in number. E1, E2, dash dash up to EN. And if we take inner product of these unit vectors EI and EJ, if this is equal to delta IJ, where inner product of EI and EJ is equal to delta IJ, where I will have the value within these limits, J will have the value within these limits. Then EI and EJ may be orthonormal or may not be orthonormal. In what case EI and EJ will be orthonormal? If delta IJ is equal to 1. What is this delta IJ? This delta IJ is known as a Kronecker delta. So if delta IJ, the Kronecker delta obtained for inner product of EI and EJ is 1, then EI and EJ will be orthonormal vectors. Delta IJ will be equal to 1 only for the condition I is equal to j. Whenever I is equal to j, then only delta IJ will be equal to 1. If I is not equal to j, this delta ij will not be equal to 1. It means that when I is equal to j, ei and ej will be orthonormal set of vectors, orthogonal set of vectors. And when I is not equal to j, delta ij is not equal to 1, in that case this ei and ej will not be orthogonal to each other. Okay, this way the inner product of vectors is used to decide whether the given vectors are orthogonal to each other or not. If they are orthogonal to each other, inner product should be zero. I is equal to j means that we are going to find the norm of this vector. Norm of this vector will be unity. If norm is unity and two such vectors are orthogonal to each other, we can say that these are the orthonormal vectors. If norm is unity and the vectors are not orthogonal to each other, it will not be orthonormal vectors. This is what about inner product of vectors. Hope you got it. In the next lecture, we shall go for two problems on this article. Till then, thank you.